Okay, just want to start this video series off with a disclaimer. You are going to be working on an ECU if you're following this video. Any risk involved is strictly on the person working on their ECU. You cannot hold myself, Kustom Modified Racing, or HA Motorsports or any of their employees liable for any damages done to your ECU. You are modifying at your own free will. This is just an informational video to help you in your tuning needs. This video was brought to you by HA Motorsports, Honda Acura Engine Management Solutions, and Kustom Modified Racing. So these people have been very gracious to send me some kits, and I will be going through and making a total chipping video, adding VTEC and adding a 28-pin chip socket. As you can see, HA Motorsports makes it very easy with their kits. They're labeled USDM, JDM, and then you'll see numbers like this, 1720, 1980, 11F0, and your PWM boost kit. These numbers here, the 1720, 1680, and 11F0, correspond to the number on your circuit board down there. So if you see we have a 02D01720 1500, so 1720 is the number we're looking for. So we'll be using the 1720 VTEC kit and the USDM chip kit because this is a P06 ECU. We will be adding the 28-pin chip. We will be adding the 373 chip, the CN2 chip data logging. We'll go through and replace the main C14 capacitor. We have a few transistors and capacitors burned out here, so this will be kind of the worst case scenario you'll see with ECU chipping, and this will be an all-out video, so we'll get everything laid out, and let's get started. Okay, we have everything laid out. I'm going to go through everything that's needed to get started in ECU chipping. We have the chipping kit from HA Motorsports USDM, the 1720 VTEC chip kit. They sent me some chip quick solder flux for tracking and pinpointing flux into small tight joints. You're going to need some type of desoldering pump, desoldering wick. The soldering pump can be electric or manual. I have both. I prefer the electric one. You're going to need some solder, some acrylic conformal coating for when you're done, an adjustable soldering iron, some brake clean, some alcohol prep pads, and a magnifying glass. We're going to work first here in the 27256 area, the 373 area, the CN2 area, the C51, C52 area, the R54J1 area. Basically, this whole bottom right corner of the ECU board. So we're going to get all these little points desoldered, and we'll come back and talk about them. Okay, here we are at the P06 ECU board. The way it's oriented is the ECU plugs are to the left, and the sticker of the ECU identifier is here on the bottom. So we're working in the right lower corner area here. So the very first thing that I like to do is add the CN2 Datalogger. Now you can go in any order that you want, but this is the way I like to do it. So we'll get the Datalogger from HA Motorsports, and usually they're going to have some type of backing plate or some type of hump here. So the flat part is always going to go against the back of the ECU. And then we're going to be looking at CN2 there. And if you see, you've got 1 through 5. You're only going to be using holes 1 through 4. So we'll drop the data logging connector straight down into the board. And there it is. There's your CN2 data log. So we're going to get that soldered in. Okay, now that we get the CN2 data logging port in, let's move on to the smaller components like the C51 and the C52, which is the 0.1 microfarad conditioning capacitors. I also forgot to mention, make sure you always put a little flux on the tips of all your solder joints there. Make sure that all the solder is flowing neatly and nicely, and all your joints end up coming out looking phenomenal. Alright, so we're going to move on to the C51 area, which is right next to this 373 latching chip. So right here is your C51. Let's get one of those out and let's get it in place. Alright, we got the C51 right here, 0.1 microfarad conditioning capacitor put in, and the C52 conditioning capacitor, both 0.1 microfarads. Some tuners say they're not needed. The spots are there. I like to put them in, and that's just the way I like to do it. Everybody's going to do it differently. You got your R54 and your J1 that have to go in now. Your J1 is a 0-ohm resistor. It's just a jumper wire, so you can use a 0-ohm resistor or any piece of wire. And the R54, I think, is like a 1.2K ohm. So let's get those installed. Okay, we're moving on now to the J1 and the R54 area right above the 28-pin chip. So we'll insert the J1, which is a 0-ohm resistor. Try and get this in focus here. Come on. It's got one stripe. So it's a 0-ohm resistor. That's going to go in J1. And then we have a 1.2K resistor. 1.2K ohm resistor. And that's going to go in the R54 spot. So let's get those in. Okay. After you install J1 and R54, we're going to move on to the 737 chip area. Before that, I want to lift up the ECU and show you. If you can see the resistors, I leave them slightly off the board. If you see, most of the resistors on the board are touching. I like to leave mine off because resistors do get hot, and I don't want any extra heat on the board that's not needed. So I leave a little air gap off the board so that they can, you know, properly vent heat and everything. So let's get that 737 chip in. We'll drop it in. We'll get that soldered. When you're putting in these IC chips, these latching chips, they have a half cutout shape here. They got to correspond with that half cutout shape on the board down there. So if you see the half moon, the half cutout, the half circle, whatever you want to call it, lines up. So make sure you put them in like that. Let's get this chip installed. Okay, we got the 373 chip in, which is the IC4 slot right there. Let's work on the 27256 area. We're going to drop in the zero insertion ZIF, I guess, plug. I'm not sure what you want to call it. It came pre-assembled. There's two parts to it. There's a machine part that goes into the board, and then another part that clips onto the top of it. But HA Motorsports sends it together. That is better, sending them together, because people can bend the pins. So we're going to drop this into the spot right here. Again, with your latching device, half moon. If you see there, you got the half cut out there. Sorry for the camera focus. You got your half cut out there, and you got your latch up top. That's going to go right where that half moon and latch is. So always remember, follow the circuitry on the board. Let's get this chip installed. Just wanted to get a close-up of the board here. You do put a little bit of flux on each one of the joints. I have something underneath it holding the chip in, I just wanted to give that little tip because the chip will, or the ZIF socket will start to fall out. So just prop something up underneath the board down here, screwdriver or whatever, and just hold that chip in place and then begin the solder. Okay, after you get the 28-pin quick disconnect socket latch in there, you can go ahead and drop your chip in there. And it's an authentic SST chip from HA Motorsports. Again, lining up with the half notch. It'll just drop right in there. And then you would latch it over. And that chip is in there, but it's blank. It's not going to do anything for you right now. It's got to be programmed. So, we'll move on to the last part of the USDM chipping kit, which will be the replacement of the C14 capacitor, which is right down there. That's your C14 main board capacitor. It's always a good idea to go ahead and replace that while you're in there, and HA Motorsports does supply that in the kit. So let's get the capacitor out and we'll talk about it for a second. Okay, so we have the new capacitor here from HA Motorsports. It is a 220 microfarad 35 volt capacitor, 105 degrees Celsius. That is your standard replacement cap for this board. As you can see, the old cap on there is much bigger, although it is the same specs. 105 Celsius, 220 microfarad with a 35 volt rate. You're going to notice one side has a stripe on it and one leg is longer than the other. So the stripe is going to face the stripe on the board. That is the negative side, the short side. The long positive side is going to go in the plus. So when you bring it down into the board, the long plus side to the left, the small leg to the right. And as you can see, it's almost the notch, that silver line matches right there on the board for negative. Make sure you keep the polarity correct. And I, like I said, I bring it down and I keep it just slightly off the board. I don't want anything to be directly on the board for heat purposes and everything else. So once that's in, that stays pretty snug. It doesn't fall out. Get some flux on there. We'll get it soldered in. Okay, we got the C14 installed, the main capacitor on the board. And that concludes the USDM chip kit from HA Motorsports install. Let's recap and let's go over some things that we went through. I'll bring the ECU closer so everybody can see. All right, what we installed here was a 28-pin chip with a quick disconnect ZIF socket. We installed a J10 ohm resistor, an R54 1.2 K ohm resistor. We installed C51 and C52, which is a 0.1 microfarad conditioning capacitor. We installed IC4, which is the 373 chip. We installed the CN2 4-pin data logger. And we installed C14 main capacitor in the board. This is one of the most complete kits you can find on the market. So again, visit my friends at HA Motorsport. They have complete kits and they sponsored this video. Shout out to them. The next video we're going to be working on is the top left area around the D1, the IC14 area, all in this area. And up here, we will be adding the 1720 VTEC conversion so that this ECU can operate like a P28 or any VTEC ECU. That'll be in the second installment of videos. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe.